Yeah, what is up, everybody? Brian with you from the Game Company. We are playing some more Humankind, and well, we're having some issues here with Humankind. So, last week, I went to go do some more recording of our Mexican campaign and get some more of the festivals done for our Dia de los Muertos challenge that we're trying to accomplish here in November. And I was trying to figure out how much we had already done. You know, I was like, surely there's somewhere in the game that you can track it. Surely there's somewhere for you to actually see what you've done and what you still need to do and so on and so forth. And like, I was looking all over the game, couldn't find it anywhere, ended up Googling it, and no one was really having that problem. And I was like, what the heck is going on? Well, it turns out that you have to actually connect your Games Together account before you can actually get any of the challenges. Now, the funny thing about that is I have purposely just never bothered to connect it. Why haven't I connected it? Just, I had no reason to. Like, okay, sure, I could upload my dude so you guys could play, but like, I just never really did it. More than that, like, I don't really care to necessarily get a bunch of different avatars to play against. Although, you know, maybe it's cool because you could get some more randomized people. But anyways, I just never got around to doing it. So I ended up connecting it only to find out that we basically had none of our stuff saved. And then, of course, today, to rub salt on the wounds, when I launched the game, now it tells you connect to Games Together and complete them to earn rewards. And I'm like, you gotta be freaking kidding me. The funny thing is, it never, ever, ever told us that you had to connect it ever until today. And I'm like, you gotta be kidding me. So, needless to say, I did rage quit the game for the weekend, and I'm just like, oi. And then today, we tried starting another campaign, and we got stuck on a tiny island all by ourselves. Like, I'm talking, it literally had 5 territories on the island, and all the islands around us were already completely colonized. And I'm like, what the actual heck? The game hates me right now. So, we've gotten some of this stuff, because I've done a little bit of playing this weekend. Like, we have 10 of the 50 Civil Evolution stuff. This one won't be the hardest thing to do. Army of Darkness won't be that bad. We just need to be a militaristic culture and then use their ability 4 times in one era. We just need to be the Maya Aztecs and then like rush out of wonder or something like that. And then the 20 public festivals we can do. We just need more population, and we just need to make sure we actually get Maker's Quarters to begin with. Then the Distrito Federal, that one's not going to be that big of a deal. We just need to get a bunch of population, merge them together, and World Faith might be a little harder. So ultimately, I think this is how we're going to end up having to play the game. I think we're going to have to go super aggressive. I think we're going to have to, like, not necessarily, like, we don't want to conquer everyone, because if we conquer everyone, we win the game. So we want to get a majority of the land as ours and majority of the cities as ours, because then we can start merging them, and then that will help us get to the 300 population. That'll also help us with the World Faith, and then, you know, going ahead and spending a bunch of population won't be the worst thing in the world either. So we're going to go ahead and launch a new game. We're going to randomize everything again. We are going to stay on civilization difficulty. And then they also have these in conditions now. Although you have to go to custom, because if you do default, it like has them all off and you just can't win the game, which is weird. Although technically they're not off. Weird. Weird. But whatever. Okay, nope, they're on. I don't know why they were turned off earlier when I was launching in. So okay, hopefully. Oh, the only thing I changed is we did bump rivers up. So rivers are like a mini, just because we want a lot of food, and rivers are like the best way to get a bunch of food. So because of that, you know, we have rivers basically maxed out. I should maybe have like bumped down sea level or something like that so we could get the most land, but that I'm not as concerned about. Like, what are the odds that we spawn on an island all to ourselves? Like, I don't mind being an island all to myself. And in fact, the irony is we were actually cruising on that island all to ourselves. Like, I had never gotten more science and got out of that first era as quickly as I did, or at least the second era, because we kept finding all these curiosities, and it was just on such a small little island that it was just curiosity, and we'd just go back and forth, pick up all these curiosities, and we were just like cruising. It was great. The problem is not being able to go anywhere else, and like, I don't know, it was just like frustrating, and it was like, man, I need more land. Did you seriously freeze on me now? Dude, this game hates me. This game freaking hates me. It actually froze. Oh my gosh. All right, well, give me a minute and we'll be back. All right, well, we're loading back into the game, and well, the biggest issue we kind of have right now with this game is the fact that like this is a timed event and we only have till the end of November to do it, which I don't understand that. Like, why make the event timed? Like, there's no reason to make it timed. Like, let me complete it whenever. Like, it's just a cool skin. Like, the event's awesome. Love the idea, but why is it timed? I don't know. Anyways, so today is Monday, November 22nd. So we are running a bit out of time to actually complete this. Can I not be in Tundra, please? Like, is that possible, game?
There is
oh my gosh. I mean, maybe the tundra's not so bad, but nah, screw this, dude. We're just going to go ahead and restart. I don't want to be in the tundra. Like, maybe there's a way to change this. World shape, I don't care about. Continent shape, I don't care about. Climate, let's actually do forest and jungles. Savannas. You know what? Let's just do standard. Yeah, let's do standard so hopefully we don't get stuck in a super tundra map. Because that could be happening here. And then everything else I think I'm fine with still. Okay, yeah, we'll try that. But yeah, the point being is we're going to have to kind of rush this out here to actually finish everything before the end of the month, which I'm a little concerned with being able to finish everything in time because, you know, we do have American Thanksgiving, which, you know, I should be able to record that day. I do have, like, a lot of work I got to do here the next couple weeks, too, but I think I'm going to be able to bulk record this enough. But point being, we're going to have to just be on our game here to actually get this rushed out in time so we can actually get the thing. So I'm less concerned about winning a game right now. I'm more concerned about just popping out. This is actually an awesome area, by the way. I love this area. But I'm more concerned about actually, and also the fact that we started on the river is kind of cool. But yeah, I'm more concerned about, okay, that's a dead end over there. I'm more concerned about completing this event, dang it.
Leave the greatest mark.
He sounded like he was saying something new there. I don't know. Can I get a sign star here? Because I would love to go settle over there. Are you seriously in my way, buddy? Oi, he's in my way. And he's on a nice little spot that I don't really want to fight. So I guess we're going to jump on the food here, which is unfortunate. That gave us 15 food.
If you washed it first.
So killing that deer, if that deer comes back, would not be the worst thing in the world. Because that would put us at 20. But never mind, we will hit 20 here. Yeah. And then we have one extra. I don't really like this right now, though. So we're going to send one up here. Actually, hold up. You go raise this lair. We might need to merge these guys again. So you're going to go here. We got to raise this. We don't want to hit it the next era with the population, man. We'd much rather hit the next era with the science. But, you know, I mean, if we hit it with the population, maybe we just hit it with the population. Okay, so you actually maxed out there. That gave us 20 food. I guess 15 food. Dang. We definitely got the rivers on this map, though. The downside is we don't have any culture. And so because of that, we're kind of screwed. And then there's another pop as well. Okay. Where are all the scientific things, though, man? Where are all my scientific things? We've almost hit the next era. My God. All we have to do is kill this deer and we're in the next era or raise the sanctuary. Or actually just merge these two. Okay. Now, not having any city is kind of weird. For sure. For sure. I guess let's go. And now the question is, who do we want to grab? So I've been kind of in the agenda that we should just grab the Hittites. The thing is, I don't know we're really going to want any early war, but just getting that plus combat strength for the rest of the game seems really awesome. And what's really cool here is we can grab the reduction here on the heavy cav industry costs, which then might help us as the Huns. Although actually, now that I think about it, I don't think the Huns units are heavy cav. But, you know, any chariots like that are going to be cheaper to produce. Do we have horses out here? We have a horse. We have a horse. Yeah, not actually a lot of amenities. A lot of rivers, but not a lot of amenities. What would be the other options here? Go Babylons for science. The Egyptians for the extra production so we can get wonders. Obviously, the Harpins. Sorry, I always say them wrong. The Harpins, whatever, for the extra food might not be the worst thing in the world. I think we just grab the Hittites. Because the worst thing that could happen for us is for us to pass up on the Hittites and then someone else to grab the Hittites, like our neighbor. And then all of a sudden we're dealing with that Hittite plus one combat strength the entire game. Plus we're on a harder difficulty. So, you know, it just gets even harder then. Okay, so let's see. You're at 23.4, 25.2. I mean, that's crazy growth here. I don't necessarily want that much growth, though. That's 26. That seems pretty dang good. So we'll grab you then. Now, unfortunately, nothing is going to really pop out here. We'll want this territory, but yeah, let's just start exploring then. At least we have lots of units. Actually, hey, stay here. Stay here! Stay there! God dang it. Yeah, I want the money, man. I want the money. And then you're already on this river, so yeah, just come down here then. Oh, we have three people on this one. Yeah, I probably don't need three groups in this one. But at least we have enough people that we can go fight someone else. No, you dang it, game. I literally clicked. You saw me. You saw me click the one and then click somewhere else. That game screwed me right there. Just throwing that one out. I need to send you this way, by the way. God dang it. We're going to do it. Waste my freaking turn. That was a big waste turn, man. It's seriously a bit of a waste of a turn. All right, you're going to become a city. Yay. Cool. How much until we get the next one? Like, a lot. Okay, that's fine. So, 7 food, 8 production. We'll grab the food, and then we probably want to go straight into the production building. All right, Brian, do this correctly here. 1 unit. Thank you. Move you two here. 1 unit. There. You come over here. Okay, cool. We're actually going in separate directions for once. Let's send you out over here and just like see what's over here. We don't even have our whole like home territory explored yet, which is kind of hilarious. We'll take you over here. We can fight the deer because river crossing. And actually, know what we can do? We can go here. And he'll probably attack us from this direction. But if he attacks us from this direction, ah, dang it. That's okay. If he attacked us from that direction, he would have the river crossing, which would just be awesome for us. He'll charge up here. Actually, we should attack down because he'll actually climb up here and attack. And I think... Actually, that's a good question. I should have seen what the hill was. I don't know if attacking down the hill would have... Yeah, I don't know if that was actually better for us. Maybe should have let him attack us because we would have still had the defense boost. All right, interesting little bit of the map down here. We'll go there. I could auto-explore these guys, but I don't like auto-exploring. I like it's fun to actually discover the map. That's kind of the whole point. We got a lot of rivers here. Definitely a lot of rivers. You're just going to come here, and we're just grabbing all of these because we can rush out buildings. So, yeah. A little weird that I've not seen curiosity. Also, how does that not give me any vision here? That's very strange. Also, that's a dead end, which kind of sucks, and we're kind of trapped over there. Sure. Yeah. So go here. Go here. Does reveal all the way down here. You're already over there, so that's fine. So we do have copper here, by the way. Wait, who's attacking us? Got hit by a bear? Where'd the bear come from? And a bear came at us. Yeah, that's fine. Might want to run up there eventually. Okay, so the bear was here, and instead of coming over here and attacking down, he actually came this way. All right, well, just hold your ground then. And goodbye, bear. Goodbye, bear. That's what you get, bear. So there's a bear spawner somewhere over here probably then. It's a friendly sanctuary. Interesting. I don't know how I feel on this map this far. Don't really like it. I mean, it's got the rivers at least, but we discovered a forest. Congratulations. It doesn't actually give us anything. I would like a natural wonder would be preferable here, but that's okay. Culture is just hot trash right now. Money is decent enough that we can rush you out. And then, yeah, let's get the industry popping out here. I think that's going to be fine long term. Because we can do food here, and then I guess we keep the industry on the river? I don't know, we'll have to see how that works. So, put you up here, and we'll fill in this, which is exactly what happened, and then you can come over here. Okay, then with you, my friend, you're going to spend your whole turn like that. Hey, that's what we're looking for, discoveries. Sweet. So hopefully this is going to give us a bunch of culture, not just money. And it gave us money. all right, well, we have silver. We have no luxury resources here, man, which sucks. Salt's good, though, because that's extra food. But, like, look, there's no luxury resources. Dude, our last island, that single island we were on that I was telling you about, was way better than this. Like, we had so many luxury resources, it was kind of crazy. Maybe I should have bumped up luxury resources as well. Do we want to restart? Part of me is yes. I'm not gonna lie. I think we are. And this would be probably our last one. There was nothing wrong with that map. Hear me out. I was totally okay with that map, except for the lack of luxury resources. So I think what we want to do here, and the whole reason I want a bunch of stuff for luxury resources, because remember, we're trying to get as much population as possible. So the more luxury resources that we get, the better off we are. I think I'm also going to do a bundle on the strategic. We'll do normal on the strategic. I actually don't care about that. All right, we'll do that one more time. But yeah, we just need as much as possible. So that's what we're going to do. We're gonna just do this one more time. Hopefully get exactly what we need. Or not even exactly what we need, just something that's a little better than that. I'm being very picky here. That being said, that territory itself was actually pretty freaking baller, dude. It just kind of sucked because A, we didn't get any of those science stars, so we didn't get the ability to throw our city down right away, and then we also didn't get any like of the science stars after we hit the first era, so we're just kind of like behind the eight ball on that. So no river here in our first town, which, you know, obvious, and we're on a tiny little island, which, why not? Although there are horses and copper. 14-3, 12-6 is 18. 15, 14. 7 plus 8 is 15. It was 18. Got only 5 production, though. Kind of shucks. But I think we do that. Hold up here. Yeah, this is the edge of the map here. Cool. Well, we are halfway to the next era. Dude, wait. Is this dead-ended over here? No, I don't think so. Dude, did we get stuck again? Dude, does the game hate me this much?
Wonderful stuff.
Are you kidding me right now? 15. This was 18 as well. I think I'd rather do 12-6 than 13-5. Dude, are you kidding? I think... And then there's red right there as well. What the actual heck? Give me the refugee party, please. We have no food here. So we'll send you out over this way. We're going to send you out this way. And then you can go grab that. Dude, if this is a freaking dead end here, I'm going to laugh. No. Okay. What the hell? Dude, no. This is a two-tile island. Are you kidding me? This is a two-tile island! No way! No freaking way! Dude, I think it is! 15 to 20. Maybe. You know what? Maybe not. Maybe not. We're at 9 to 10. This is still just one territory right here, which is kind of hilarious. We actually hit the next era. Okay. I think we're okay. Yeah, I don't think we're actually, like, completely screwed. We want plant lore here. Next era, I'll get one extra food. So let's hold off. Yeah, let's hold off entering the new era.
A first outpost means a first,
because this will give us one extra pop. And let's see. We lose food now. Give me the Bountiful. Ooh, or we could get cheaper domestication. I think I'd rather still have Bountiful. Domestication isn't really that expensive, so. I don't know those give us anything. I mean, extra, culture, I suppose, so. Then you hit 5 here. This is so freaking strange. All right, we're going to hit the next era, but dude, I do not feel good about this one. I do not feel good about this one. Although, maybe we're attached to him and we can do something with that. I don't know. This is a very strange map.
Ah, the challenges.
This is a very, very strange one.
Benefits of the market and move ahead.
So, all right, new era. Hittite seas can be created by selecting. Yes, yeah, I know how to do that. Thank you. Go ahead and auto explore some of you. And then we're going to go take you and make you into an outpost or into a city, please, and thank you. And then, yes, and 9 production. Okay. Okay. Find a sanctuary here. We shall go raise that. Like, the funny thing is, well, I don't have enough influence to put another outpost down here, but, like, I kind of want to. Actually, maybe I should have made this an outpost before I got the next era, because it's a lot cheaper. But that's okay. First science, we shall do domestication. Yeah, we got a horse. That's fine. Gives us some extra food. The Harapans, the Harapians, whatever, they got settled. Okay. We at least have saffron here, so that's some food. And then we have silk gold, which is money. No luxury resources. Remember how we bumped up the luxury resources so we'd see more? Yeah. I don't... yeah, surely we didn't do that. Clearly. Clearly not. What the heck, dude? Oh, and we're now... oops. We're attacking? Also, I have 2 guys in here. I don't think I realized that. So, let's go ahead and end deployment. I actually did not want to end deployment. That was a bit of a mistake. You run here. We got the river advantage, so we're just going to defend. And he's going to go up. But he didn't attack on the river, so that's good for us. 54 damage. And then let's just move you here and put you there. And then end round. And now he should die. And then we took a... Ah! Yeah, actually, it looks like the river might hurt worse than the hills. I don't know. That's a good question. And you're stuck? You're stuck. Okay, that's fine. Also, you need to swap these two. Okay, there's a lot more territory down here. Oh, thank God. I was about to get kind of salty. Let's go. All right, so you guys have to come this way. There's really no other option. Wow, this is just really awkward, man. And now we're getting attacked by a bear in literally the exact same spot. So, okay, well, we learned our lesson last time. So, how much is the river crossing? It's -3. I think the hill is a 4 advantage, I thought. Might be. Yeah. All right, we're going to do the same thing. End around. It might just be because we have the extra combat strength, too, that we're just destroying them. All right, well, bear dead. So, I need to send... Actually, let's send the more hurt guy this way. Because you're here to actually put a... Wait. Oh, this is the area. Okay. This one... okay, so it's either here or here. But what's weird about this... Oh, yeah, I don't know how I feel about this. Yeah, this is a very interesting little land here. I don't really like it. Of course, you gotta go up there. So this is 61. The thing is, I don't know if this is gonna be better right here with these three, or if it's gonna be better over here. That's the thing that's a little strange for me right now. Let's go, like, right down here, just for the time being. And then I have 2 pop. So, bring them both here, and we'll go ahead and attack. I mean, this is free money, so I might as well take it. Okay, so this is a river crossing. There's no way to defend without the river. I could defend here and here. Actually, I can't end deployment like that. So if he comes up, he's going to have to attack me from here first. So I think we go here. Because he can't get here to attack this guy. No, he's actually going to defend. What?
Follow me.
What?
Up we go.
I've never seen the deer actually not suicide. Okay, I was going to say, well, we're going to lose this battle then, and I'm just going to be okay with that. All right, so let's see. So he's, we got the height advantage and the river. Well, actually, the river counteracts each other. So the height is +4, where the river's only 3. That's fine. We'll hurt the one guy. Kill you off, then the other guy can go do his own thing. Okay, that's another 5 gold. We might actually be able to rush you out. Yes, we can. Let's go ahead and get our first district. Maker's Quarter, please. Thank you. We need one more turn here. Can you actually get up there? You actually can. 9, 12. 4, 8. 9, 6. 7, 8. 7, 7. 8, 7. 15, 6. 12, 7. Yeah, so definitely one of these two. Might as well do it on the outpost, like where we're currently at. Because why not? Why not? All right, you two are going to split off. Take you, run you off the river. Then grab this guy and send him down this way. Where's all my luxury resources, game? Seriously, what the hell? Okay, here's some more. How much is it here now? 124. Yeah. This is fine. And it looks like he's got an island to himself right here. Like adjacent to our island. It looks like we're kind of like next to each other, which is kind of cool. Not gonna lie. Is this another river? Yeah, it looks like it. I'm just trying to, like, I would like you to heal. I guess there's really no easy way to do it. So yeah, you go here and then heal you up. You go grab this. More gold. Not what we want to see. I mean, yeah, not really what I want to see. How about that? When you come over here, probably put some of these guys in auto here in a sec. More horse here. Okay. So the Hittite unit requires 2 horses and 1 copper. So we got 1 horse, we got 2 horse, we got a copper. That's good. Domestication, God, see, this is the problem, is we're just not getting a lot of science right now, which is why we would love to be seeing some more science from these guys, but you're trapped. It's going to take, all these rivers are making it really hard to move around, though. So, you know, there is a disadvantage to the rivers. Ah, thank God. Ah, finally, it gave us science. Okay, that's what we needed. All right, so domestication's done. Let's go grab calendar probably next. And yeah, I suppose we got a decent amount of things now. Okay, so let's put you on auto. And the next era requires 124. Yeah. This area might be cheaper. Because it's adjacent, because this one is not adjacent. So that might be why we want to grab this one next. Now, the other thing that we want to do is we want to grab the one civic that makes these cheaper before we probably settle more territory. Downside being that we got to actually get it unlocked first. Hopefully, yeah, it looks like this island's to ourselves. So it looks like everyone kind of got a vertical island, which is okay. This is coffee, which is food again, which we love to see. More saffron over here, which is more food. More food. Okay, yeah, we ended up with enough. Yeah, this is fine. This is fine. So 124, 74. Okay, yeah, much cheaper this area. Then let's put you on auto explore. I don't really care. Go find me some science things. And yeah, it looks like we have an island to ourselves. But once again, I'm okay with this island compared to the previous one. This island is much, 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 much better. And yeah, we actually have you right there too, which is not bad. More science. Good. Good, 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 good. We love to see the extra science right now. Just so we can cruise through these techs. Also, it gives us extra culture, which means we can go settle on these guys a little quicker. So, next turn, you'll be able to grab something here. Ransack successful. This is fine. 9 and 12. That's fine by me. We also want to go ahead and connect, but I'm going to have to wait. It's only 30, so it's not that bad. And actually, there you go. So, let's go ahead and connect the first one then. Attach. Aerostar unlocked. Beautiful. So, let's go grab horse. And then we're probably going to go for animal husbandry just to get the food knocked out. You don't really have anywhere else to go, so we're just going to take you up the hill. Beautiful. Gold. Don't really want, but that's okay. How expensive are you? 139. That sucks, but okay, carpentry, I guess, for now. We are basically running to the edge of the island at this point. So, that's okay. Double science stars over here. Nice. Nice, nice, nice. That's going to be a bunch of culture, hopefully, in science. Or money. Speaking of which, we got to be rushing things out, Brian. And then artisan quarter for gold. That just gives us money. which I don't know I care so much about. So maybe we pop out the pottery workshop then. And then maybe another district. So the question is, what are we going to do next era? Number one, we're way far behind. I bet everyone else is, nah, we're not that far behind. But the question is, I don't think we want the Huns. I don't think we want the Huns because we're not adjacent to anyone. Celts is probably where we want to go for the food. Then again, maybe some production. I mean, if we're conquering everyone, I suppose the food isn't as, like, necessary. So, but a militaristic star is not necessarily that useful, as we're seeing. At least not right this second. Okay, that gave us some more science. Two turns left. That gave us gold. Still two turns left. All right. We pretty much have everything explored, so let's just go auto-explore everyone now. Because there's nothing else for us to grab. What are you doing? Weren't you supposed to get this last turn? I think so. Okay, and more money. Not that we wanted money, but okay, we can rush you out. So, pop out the animal barns. How many territories is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it's 7 as opposed to the 5 one I had earlier. They finally hit the freaking ancient era? Wow, that was actually kind of horrible. Yeah, I thought we had... I mean, I didn't think we had a bad start, but okay. Could be worse, I suppose. Could be worse. There we go. There we go. There we go. So we don't want those. I mean, we do, but we want create outposts cheaper. And then, yeah, give me the extra 5 culture. Sorry, influence. So these guys are going to be significantly cheaper to found now. And we probably want to go ahead and work on this next territory over. And I think we probably want a city. What about a city down here? How much is this? 70 influence. It's not that bad. You're in the same zone. Actually, you know what? This seems like the zone, right? Yeah, this seems like a good zone right here to throw a city. So let's take you this way then. And we'll figure out what we're doing then. City defense is 3 turns. Nice. City defense is done. I literally was about to say that right before we clicked it. Because I was like, we're going to totally get the science from it right now, aren't we? And yeah, actually. So this is 70. This zone is also 70. So I think then next turn we throw a city down here somewhere. And you go auto. Actually, take me up here. Yeah, because I might want to go something up there. All right, so we're going to want to get to naval transports. So let's pop our emblematic unit, because we know there's an island here. We know there's probably an island there, and then we have a neighbor up there. So these are all things we got to like knock out here sooner rather than later. Okay, so what kind of outposts? We have 21-4, 17-7. I think I'll take the 17-7. What do you got over here? 18-10. Oh, dang. Wait, was that 27-7 or 27? 17-7. That's 24. This is 18-10. That's 28. That's a better city, man. All right. Well, let's do it here then. That's going to be a better city for us. So... put you on auto explore then. Yeah, and then we got the money. I'll go ahead and confirm, even though I'd rather spend the money rushing buildings out, but that's okay. We don't really want to like lose some population or anything like that. That would be kind of bad right now. There was a star right here, was there not? Yes, there was. So we need to make you into a city, which is gonna be like another 160 something, which is gonna kind of suck, but that's okay. That's okay. Yeah. Trying to think, there's not really much else for us to do right now then. You had horses in this territory, don't you? No. Our horses were over here, which is all interconnected to this zone. So the question is, do we want to put everything inside our zone, or would we rather go ahead and make another city first? I don't know. It's actually a really good question. Yeah, I don't know. So I'm assuming your city is going to have to go somewhere like right in here. And in fact, we might be able to get our two cities, like our two outposts here, pretty close to each other. Which can be at an advantage depending on what we're doing. By the way, Science Star, We're at 4-7. We got the one. Are we okay with this? Or do we want to rush out one of the other ones? I think we're still okay with this. So you can actually put a territory down here. Yeah, those are 53. Yeah, this is still all the same zone here. But you're not actually going to tell me what they're worth? Okay. Well then, you just keep doing what you're doing then. I really want to get over there. Clearly I can't, so... auto-explore then. And then, yeah, you're coming over here. It's going to be, what, 160, I think? Yeah, it's 160. Dang. You want to give us, like, 30 culture here? That would be kind of nice. So that's 14-12 there. 11-4, 14-6, 8-11, 6-12. Probably that, right? 6-12, 17. That's 18. And I don't think anything down here is going to be worth as much. We saw a 17 one. But yeah, I think we do it right here then. It's only 53 for some reason. I guess because it's adjacent to our home territory. All right, lucky. The ground got wetter, but the people, nightlife is normal again. I wish it actually gave you something positive. You know, give me like an infrastructure building for free or something. Yeah. I suppose that would always be worth grabbing then, but still. Still, man. All right, so you're going to throw an outpost here. Then we do have the 1412 right there. Create your own religion. These are administrative centers, or are these just... They're just a wari. Which... They're just outposts. IIRC. Which means... This would right now only give us 4 faith. This one gives us 6. But as soon as we get another city, shamanism's just way better. So I still think we wait. Yeah, I still think we wait. Okay, how long till we can get a city? 160. Come on, baby. I really want to get this city soon. So what else can you pop out? Just gold, right? I don't think we want the gold. I mean, it's 3 money. And then it's 2% money per gold. So it's like... Not really that much. We're still fine on food. What about a harbor? We don't have that unlocked yet. Let's grab another farmer's quarter. Then again, do we want to grab farmer's quarters now? Because if we grab the Celts next turn, those are farmer's quarters. So actually, I say maybe not. Maybe not. We have 33 industry already, which is kind of nice. 2 food per farmers. I mean... Yeah, maybe I just want another industrial zone. We don't have copper yet. Did we skip the copper? We skipped bronze working, didn't we? That's fine. Yeah, that's fine for now. Just do a granary then. Just do the granary. We're going to be boring. Animism. We do have a religion here. Let's go ahead and name it... we'll call it Jeffism. Sure. Jeffism. Congratulations. We're waiting until we get 160. This is going to be expensive to rush out, so that's fine. We're just going to auto-explore right now. Because I think I want my city next, which we'll be able to grab here in 2 turns. Never mind, we'll be able to grab it right now. We're getting attacked by a double bear. But that cannot be done as there's no retreat position. Well, that sucks. End deployment. Wait, what? No, we're getting attacked from some other dude here. Interesting. Huh. Who is this guy? Well, we're just gonna automatic battle. So we just got hit by some city. But they hadn't thrown a city out yet. Alright, well, be a little careful here. And yeah, we might want to get our guys merged up. That sucks, because it's not like we're that slow right here. Dude, just end round, man. I said just automatic battle. I don't understand why the game's like, just speed it up. The fact that they have archers already is just kind of hilarious. Like, come on, man. Come on. It's like not even fair. So they're going to throw a city down, probably over here, which I don't necessarily mind, because we can just jack it. All right, there's our expansionist star. We need 30, and we're going to go merge you. It's the quickest way down there that way. Okay, that's fine. We have horses over here. Although, I think we want to grab up here maybe first. I don't know. What do we want to do here? We have saffron, which is food. So let's grab the saffron. Actually, this is a pure territory to start with. This was not the best one, now I'm realizing. Although, our city here is just crazy good to begin with. So, that's kind of why we did it. Okay, so you're going to go throw a city over here. I don't know where he's going to go throw a town down. We just want to be careful here. And in fact, I'm just kind of trying to stay and keep vision on him, I think, is kind of our goal here. At least for the time being. We gotta wrap this episode up soon. Yeah, ish. Aristar, Agrarian Star unlocked. So you're 19.6. That's 20. That's 25, man. You kind of have to do the 25, right? Where did he go? He's right there. He can't hit us, though, yet. Unfortunately, somehow he has zone of control down a freaking mountain, which is really dumb, but that's okay. You grab that. Okay. Yeah, this is kind of bad. We need him to throw a city down soon so I can, like, jack it and run away. God dang it. Stop attacking me, man. What the hell? Leave me alone. I want nothing to do with you, my buddy. Although you're not my buddy. You're currently an enemy. But yeah. I don't even know why he's not even like attacking. He's just mercenaries. I could give them an outpost. And then just go jack it. The problem is they're also, of course, we get hit with people that like hate us. You know, we couldn't have gotten like friendly people. No. We had to get the aggressive ones. Okay, I don't want to grab that. You need to... Lumber mill is not a bad idea. 540 on the production. What we really want to do is probably rush you out. We could also go grab some faith buildings here. But... also I need to attach. There you go. You have not built any districts yet, so let's work on that. This is fine. Then we don't care about leadership. As for tech, we're going to go ahead and grab bronze working. Because bronze working we would like. All right, intern, you're going to run away. You're going to come all the way down here. Dude, he's still coming at us, man. What the hell? Leave me alone. Okay, he's going another direction. Just like settle a territory already, buddy. Jeez. So we need in here, which is going to be how much? 73 influence. We probably want to stay like right in here. It's probably going to be the ideal spot, I think. Go grab that. Go grab that. Be ready to run. Okay.
Let's go. Off we go.
So, he did put the thing down, which means I'm going to be able to jack that and make that a city. Do we want a city there, though, is the question. I kind of don't think we do. I mean, I can always merge it later. But part of me is like, maybe we just go and try ninjing it as quickly as possible. Hear me out. What if we outpost here? No. Is there no valid claims? He doesn't have... Yeah, he actually does have it now. Dang. Dang. All right. Wait, he's only at 35 combat strength. Come over here. So if we put all of our dudes together, we can actually fight him. Let's do Defiant. I don't want to spend the money. We don't really need to worry about spending the money. Okay, so I kind of want a religious building. We could pop out some units. A little bit more horsies, we could definitely. Let's go grab... Let's just grab a holy site, though. And we're going to work on it there. Now, you're still three turns. We have everything. Oh, except this one down here. So I do need one more territory down there. So he actually has a city here. God dang it. God dang it. So unfortunately, the city might actually end up growing before we can ninja it. He also somehow got a second army in almost instantly, which is really frustrating. Yeah, that's really frustrating. Independent people. I mean, we might just need to assimilate them at this point. We might need to. Aristar unlocked. This is fine. So we're going to try ninjing this. So the idea is you have to take it while it's still at zero population. Because if you grab it while it's still at zero population, then... I need one more turn here before we can run away. Because then at that point, they don't put up a fight. Oh, no, no. Run away. Run away. Run away. Shoot. Don't attack. He did not attack. Okay. He attacks. God dang it. Frick. God. Ah, I'm mad. I moved one tile too far, dude, and just absolutely screwed us. All right, so you can do gold or saffron. Let's throw down a district. There you go. We're going to be losing all of our army here. Go, 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 go. I think we got it. Woo! Ha ha! Suck it, AI. All right, so we ended up ninjaing it. That's exactly what needed to happen. Influence on main plaza and administrative center, please. That's going to give us a lot of points. Okay. 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 That's fine. That is fine. That is totally fine. Now, he still has an army marching around, but I think they just die off. I think they just slowly take damage until they throw down another outpost or something. I'm not entirely sure how that works. Okay, we also would like to throw an outpost over here. Hold up. Grab this while you're here. So let's see what we got. 8-7 might be our best. 13-5 is actually 18. This is 20. That's 18. All right, we'll go for the 20. Probably not going to be able to beat the 20. Well, hopefully they don't attack us. That'd be kind of hilarious. So, how we looking? We need one more builder star, and I need one more tech. We'll probably want to finish both of those, honestly. Yeah, we'll probably want to finish both of those. Now, luxuries are kind of eh. But you know what? We can actually fix that. Because this also counts as a district. Ooh, it costs more. I think I'm still okay with that, because we can rush it out. Because remember, those cost a district, which makes no sense to me, but that's fine. I need to grab this before I claim a wonder. Also, I think we probably would rather have a second era wonder.
Permanent settlement.
You are now attacking my city.
Quite the globe-spanning imperialist you've become.
I don't think we're going to hold this. Because he's also attacking downhill. Yeah, we're going to end up losing this town. Dang it! Alright, our ninja kind of failed miserably then. Because we didn't get an extra population from this. Crap. Alright, well, we're going to have to assimilate them. But you know what? That's fine. Because they can build some districts for us, I guess. Wait, still counts as my city? Oh, he attacked my unit. He didn't actually attack this city. Oh, interesting. Hmm. Interesting. Can you just like piss off then? He's in decline. Which I think means they're just gonna die. Yeah, except he's just killing our dudes. That's just the thing that sucks. Can I get a pop here? Next turn. I think I'm gonna pop out a warrior. I think is what we're gonna do. So I can grab that. Whatever these things are called. Curiosity. 20 gold. Not bad. Yeah, so these guys are all in decline. The downside is they ended up killing all my dudes first, which is really annoying. But yes, okay. Because now I only have one dude here to actually discover curiosities. Oh, you're actually dead end over there. Okay, so new wonder can be claimed. Once again, I don't know there's a wonder we want. Actually, you know what? The pyramids might not be bad. It makes all our districts 25% cheaper for us the game. I actually do think we claim that. The other thing is Stonehenge is food, but meh. And faith as well, but getting cheaper district costs the rest of the game just seems crazy. Because that's like a permanent buff, man. So, by the way, we need to do some more attaching. I don't have any stuff right now, though. That's okay. You have a pop. There's no available spawn point. Right there. Weird. Alright, rush you out. And we hit the next era. Good. Good. Scientist star's been earned. Builder star's been earned. And we'll grab the corpse here. So, how close are we to any other star? May wait on the money one. We're making 35 a turn. That means we're two turns away from getting the money one. Yeah, I say we wait on that. I say we wait on that. Nothing else is really going to finish in time. We did finish our holy site. We can get swift, get some money, or get extra stability. Give me swift. And I kind of want another unit, I'm not going to lie, but let's get the copper. Yeah, because then we can go ahead and work on the forge as well. And we can start getting our unique unit here popping pretty quick as well. I need 130 to attach you. Let's see. We want to attach you as well, but there's no horses here. Although, you know what we could do right now is I could spend 25 for that. And that's just significantly cheaper for us. We could also spend money on those as well. So that gives us two horses. There's only one copper. Yeah, there's only one copper, which kind of sucks, but that's okay. So we're going to wait till next two turns. We're actually all maxed out right now. Kind of crazy. Let's start here with masonry, but we don't want to finish the tech. Where was his army? I think that's his army over there, so I think we're safe to go explore. Remind me later. And we're just going to, like, come down over here and hopefully find some more stuff, but... Okay, they hit the next era. There's the merchant star. We actually got that right away. So then, let's go ahead and hit the next era. They took the Celts. You son of a gun! They take the Celts this turn? Do they really take the Celts this turn? Nope. Okay, that's fine. Alright, so then who do we want here? Plus two city cap. Nah, probably not. We could get Mayan. We could do Mayans because we do need to rush out a bunch of the Mayans. We could grab Huns, but I just don't see that. Guiding Light. Here's the other problem with the Huns is you can't actually attach this to cities, which is kind of annoying. Carthaginians. Greeks gives us extra science. We could stay as the Hittites. But the Hittites just don't help us. Their district's just kind of blah. Maybe we do the Archimede Persians, because we want to conquer the entire world. I think we do that. And that just allows us to have extra cities for the rest of the game, which is what we want. Because when we go conquer everyone, we're going to need those extra cities. So, yeah. All right, Jeffism is now officially spreading. Good. Good, and then let's see our units moving. Hopefully that guy's gonna die off here pretty quick. And then hopefully we get some... I'll put you on automatic, actually, probably next turn. I think he might have died off. But yeah, just keep exploring. All right, and then what are we gonna build here? Oh, let's go ahead and grab the forge building then. Cool, in turn. Great. Yeah, we've never played the Archimedean Persians, though, either, so. All right, well, we gotta wrap this first episode up. We are now the Persians, cool. They want expansion of stars? That actually is not bad, then. And then, under one banner, target another outpost to forcibly add it. Eh, Yeah, probably not going to happen, but, you know, we could do that potentially. But for now, I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. If you did, drop a like, comment, let me know what you think. As always, hit the subscribe button, join the game comment, and share your support. We will finish Masonry, and then from there, we need to immediately go into Trade Expeditions. Please. Now, next turn, we have to hit the Aztecs. We have to hit the Aztecs. So is there a problem that we didn't take the Mayans when we could have? No, because I think we can get the Aztecs. I do, because aren't Aztecs militaristic? And usually the militaristic stars aren't like the most priority one. They are, no, they're actually a builder one. Okay, that might be a little harder. But that's okay. That's okay. Anyways, like I said, hope you enjoyed it. See you guys later. Bye, everyone.